Coming up this weekend at heavyweight for the title of most interesting heavyweight, and that's a pretty crazy one to try and grab, we have Moldova's own Alexandr Romanov taking on the mountain Jared Vanderaa. And Matt, you talk about interesting. I don't know what there is to say. Watch the way these guys fight. Watch their post-fight or pre-fight interviews. It's just a whole weird bucket of muscles. It's a whole lot of crazy. It's a cosmic gumbo, some would say, that plays to the rhythm of jazz. And if you get the I think you should leave reference, I like you. Matt, when I look at this fight, it's straight up weird. Jared Vanderaa is one of those guys that just wears on people. He just wears on you. You have to hold his weight. He's an old-time heavyweight. He's going to push you up against. He's going to push his head in. He's going to try and take you down. He's going to land some dirty shots on the inside. And Alexandr Romanov, for what it's worth, I don't know if it's a myth. I don't know if it's real. But we got to talk about it. He's got sumo in his back pocket. And the way this guy fights, he expends so much energy in the first two rounds that his last fight out is considered a majority win. Now, I say majority. It's a technical split decision win. So, Matt, I went out there and I wrote it down. And even on the graphic, I put T-S-D-E-C-W and an asterisk because he fought Juan Espino. My guy, Juan. Where you at? And you know what? I got to kind of put down the script and stop goofing for a little bit. For Juan Espino and everybody from the Canary Islands, if you're out there, hopefully things are going well. I read about the volcano and volcanoes every day, and it really sucks for those guys. So for Juan Espino and for everybody over there, hopefully you're doing well. For Alexandr Romanov, looked like he kind of wanted a way out, which no. I never say, but man, that was rough. He was gassing hard, and it just so happened that an opportunity presented itself.
Sometimes you get hit in the balls, Craig. It just happens. Like, I understand the fight wasn't going his way, but this is something that I know I've been guilty of in the past.
Getting and kicked in the nuts?
No, it's course correcting my opinion on a fighter because of one performance that they had. I don't think having one weird bad round against Juan Espino when you had bad cardio needs to completely change my opinion about you as a fighter. I think Juan Espino is much better than just some unranked heavyweight out there in the cosmos. I think he is a borderline ranked heavyweight if you just look at his talent and you look at what he's able to do inside of an actual MMA cage.
He's a Spaniard whose background is Senegalese wrestling. It's insane. Go ahead.
I forget where I was going. Thank you. So, this is the thing about Alexandr Romanov, though. If he is able to take his opponent down, he should be able to win his fight. It is as simple as that. His striking isn't very good. His cardio isn't good either. And honestly, his straight wrestling isn't great.
His striking is weird, and that's where we got to break it down. Because if you look at it for Alexandr Romanov, he's one of those guys that could jump out and throw a front kick at you. He's the type of guy that could throw a spinning back fist or a spinning elbow. He throws a lot of energy into his shots. Obviously, we saw that when you're taking on such a good wrestler with a base like that in Juan Espino, a guy that trains out of ATT. Now you're taking on Team Quest, Jared Vanderaa, a guy with good cardio.
Was it Ellie Goulding who sang that song, "There's Something the Way You Move"? Oh, that's Alexandr Romanov, because there is something in the way he moves. He does kind of move like a bit of a fader. He's got those low hands. He's got that weird shiftiness to his hips. But the difference is that he doesn't have the explosive hand speed of a guy like Fedor Emelianenko. It is interesting because most guys use their footwork to then set up their strikes on the feet. Romanov uses his footwork to just kind of evade the strikes of his opponent and then set up. And I wish I could say, oh, he sets up a single leg and then a double leg and changes wrestling. He really only tries to get that belly-to-belly position, and then from there, he's got his PhD in that position. I know there's some guys like Daniel Cormier.
Vitaly Minnikov.
Exactly, who, from the single leg position, for instance, it's just like, oh, you know they're going to be able to get the takedown immediately. With Alexandr Romanov, it's that belly-to-belly. It's just, he has a feel for that position that not many other guys in the UFC do, and it is very unique, because every MMA fight, there is a position where you're going to be in the clinch with your opponent, and normally, that is a bit of a stalling or a bit of a pause position for most guys. That's where Romanov is at his most dangerous, and like you brought up with Jared Vanderaa, that's kind of a position that he does invite. He is somebody who likes to get ugly, likes to make the fight dirty and get on the inside. That's what worries me about Vanderaa in this fight. If he had more of those long-range weapons, and if he was able to just catch Romanov on the outside as he was trying to close the distance for that clinch, I'd like Vanderaa quite a bit in this fight. My issue is that Vanderaa is going to be doing half of Romanov's work for him. If you're the one clinching Romanov, I don't care if you have double underhooks. He has such a good understanding of the position to where he's going to fight his way through. He's going to get to the position he wants, and he's going to be able to take Jared Vanderaa down.
Were you surprised that Jared Vanderaa nearly doubled the strikes of a striker at heavyweight in Justin Taffa's last time out in a fight of the night, too?
It was a really impressive performance, and the great thing that Vanderaa showed was that he can almost use his volume as a defensive weapon. And we saw this with Alexandr Usyk against Anthony Joshua. I can't believe I'm bringing that up to describe Jared Vanderaa. But it was true. Everybody talks about how dangerous of a striker Taffa is. And he is dangerous. He's got great power. But if you can overwhelm him with volume, he will just kind of keep his hands up. What that fight proved more than anything was just high fight IQ from Vanderaa.
Yeah, so we come into this fight where Romanov has the wrestling. Vanderaa is a decent wrestler in his own right. You look at it, he was on Contender Series. He beat Harry Hunsucker, who's got a big fight coming up, old Hunsucker. You look at it at the 5-on in, the loss is Henan Fahea, who's looked pretty good since then. You got Tony Lopez that he beat, but that's a rite of passage for a big heavyweight. Sergey Spivak did it. Sergey beat poor Jared Vanderaa by knockout, and then it was like, well, why is he in the UFC again? He beat Tony Lopez, and then he beats Justin Taffa in a fight of the night, and he was like, covered in blood. It was disgusting. You look at the odds for this one, gives me a little bit of pause because Romanov opened a minus 400 favorite. He's minus 471 right now. Vanderaa opened a plus 330. He's plus 330 or 351 rather. And I'm going to look on Topology. I'm going to say over under 90%.
I would agree. Yep.
Yeah, it is. So 813 total votes, 96% Romanov, 12 by decision, 49% by submission, 33% by knockout. For the 4% that have Vanderaa, 48% by knockout, Matt. I think Alexandr Romanov is going to take Jared Vanderaa down, take him into the deep waters. If Sergey Spivak could do it, I think Romanov can do it relatively early. However, if this gets past the first half of the second round, we're playing in Vanderaa's playground now, and he's probably one of those guys that works out like tires and just all metal stationary
firm
objects.
Firm strength, you know?
Yeah, he's got firm strength. So look out for Jared Vanderaa to do like a tractor pull and get the win in the later stage of this fight. But for me, I'm going to go with Romanov, and I'm going to chalk up that Espino fight to just, you know, a one-off. Cross my fingers, cross my toes.
The only thing that will lose this fight for Romanov is his cardio. If he could fight a solid 50 minutes at his pace,
he's a champ.
Yeah, like most heavyweights are probably screwed at that point. Now, when you do have such great wrestling, there is going to be some negatives that come along with that. And that, unfortunately, is Romanov's cardio. I look at this fight as Romanov's going to win this fight unless he decides to lose it. Because if he does go out there and just shoot a crazy amount of takedowns, just go for crazy hip tosses, and if he's not able to secure any of those takedowns after he initially gets them, then I could see a world where Vanderaa storms back in the third, but I do like Romanov in this fight.
Matt, in this fight, we're both going with Moldova's Alexandr Romanov to get the win and the title of craziest heavyweight and next likely opponent for Alir Latifi. Make
there
that fight. Winner of this fight gets Alir. That's a good consolation prize, eh? Yikes. Matt, I can't wait for this fight. And the rest of this card in the co-main event at 170 pounds, we have Randy Brown taking on Jared Gooden. Absolute banger in the main event at strawweight. Mackenzie Dern, Marina Rodriguez. You're not going to want to miss this. Keep it locked in with Fight Night Picks, as we always say.
Let's get into it.